Well, I said that at the end of the video, last video, and I always say, I don't know what's going to happen next, and that is very true. And something tremendous happened. So I'm going to share with the world what that is. I had a tremendous breakthrough, a game changer. And so what is that game changer? What could be so important? Just a subtle recognition, just a, or you might say a non-subtle. Let me preface this by saying, we assume that truth is something extremely subtle. It's just the opposite. It's actually what is extremely self-evident, extremely obvious, extremely non-subtle. Our problem really is subtlety. What we're doing actually involves enormous amount of subtlety and distraction, so we can be confused and not uncertain. But truth is totally self-evident. So what I was what happened was I woke up in the morning and I realized I feel so stupid. And I know that for instance, let's say we have this lump of gold and we say, I want to change this lump of gold into silver. And you say, okay, but let's say this gold is pure gold, it can't be changed at all. But we say, my will is, I desire that this be changed to silver. So is it going to change to silver? No, it's not. So what do? To honor our desire, what do? We close our eyes. So we're not seeing the lump of gold, okay? That's the first step. The second step is, we say, well, I don't know if it's changing into silver, okay, but I also don't know that it's not changing into silver. You get this? I don't know that it's not changing. It could be. I don't know, because I got my eyes closed. I can't see it. That is exactly what we've done. The pure spaciousness in which all is, enables all to be, the ground of being, cannot be changed. There's nothing that can change it. So our desire was to change it. So what we did was we turned our awareness away from it, as if like shutting our eyes, and then we said, hey, it might be changing, I don't know. I can't see what's happening to it. So it's possible it's changing. And that's all we've been doing. We've just been waiting with an unawareness. Imagining like, you know what? The will that I had to change reality, it's possible this is going to succeed. It's possible it already has succeeded. It's possible. Simply like we have our eyes closed and we can say this lump of gold is turning into silver. Yeah, it's turning into silver. It's turning into silver. Are you sure? Well, I got no evidence that it's not. No evidence that it's not, because I got my eyes closed. Now all we have to do is if we opened our eyes, we would see it hasn't changed at all. This is now, but why don't we open our eyes? Because it's called the continuity problem. If we go from tremendous belief that this gold is turning into silver, and then we open our eyes and we see, oh my gosh, it hasn't changed at all. Shock. That's called the continuity problem. So this is the huge problem we all have. Literally, we are all have our awareness shut down to reality, and we're dreaming a dream that seems to show us that it is possible for spaciousness to be changed, because we believe that form is somehow something separate from space, because we believe in form space, where there's a fist here and then there's a space around the fist. But we're talking about pure zero-dimensional spaciousness. This fist occupies pure spaciousness as much as the space around it occupies pure spaciousness. There is no boundaries whatsoever in pure spaciousness. So we're dreaming this dream that we think shows us, you know, that success is possible. And we can project our feeling like there's something wrong with what's going on. You know, this having my eyes closed, shutting my awareness down, something stupid, there's something wrong. We project it onto the dream and have the dream act it out for us. So we think it's out there, not here. We don't want to, because of our continuity fear, we don't want to just open our eyes and look at reality, because we'd see absolutely nothing has happened in pure spaciousness. Nothing whatsoever. Continuity shock, continuity fear. Okay, so this is prefacing what happened this morning. Woke up this morning, was realizing how stupid I've been. Yeah, just colossally stupid. I've been literally just closing my eyes shut and saying, well, there's no evidence that it's not changing. We're all doing that. But I was mortified, you know, mortified by it. And I'm just so stupid. How could I be so incredibly stupid? And I was stuck in this feeling of like, how can I ever get out of this? You know, I can never have respect for myself ever again for being so totally stupid to think that merely saying that I don't have any evidence that it's not changing by refusing to look at it is somehow a prospect of eventual success. That is, you know, just utter stupidity, right? Utter, total stupidity. And I'm aware this is what I've done. I'm aware of it and honest about it. And I know this was everybody's done this, but you know, they may not be so honest right at this point about it, but I do know this. This is for sure. And then, of course, there's negative thought. Whoa, don't be too honest here. Whoa, it's scary. Continuity versus scary. I said, no, look, I've got to face it. But I don't know what to do about it. And then I asked the Holy Spirit. I said, Holy Spirit, do you have anything to say about this stupidity? Because I just don't know what to do about it. It's just incredible. How can I be so stupid? It's just, it's incomprehensible stupidity. To think that we're succeeding because we refuse to look at the situation and then we say, well, therefore we say, I don't have any evidence that we're not succeeding. You know, stupid. And this is what the answer the Holy Spirit gave me. It just popped into my mind. You know, you're right. The Holy Spirit says, actually, look at it this way. The Holy Spirit says, this is how I look at it. Your total stupidity, this willful, whimsical, completely stupid tactic you're taking, is so stupid, is actually you're honoring the perfection that you are. You're honoring the perfection you are, because the only way to express your desire to change it is to be completely stupid. There isn't any other way. So the fact that we have to be, he said, stupidity cannot show up meaningfully unless there's great intelligence, right? And if you're totally stupid, it means it's in contrast to what? Total perfection. Like, gosh, how could I have been so stupid? We only say that because we know we're really intelligent. And this is like an anomaly. Like, wow, I know I'm really intelligent. Why did I do such a stupid thing? Whereas if we were really were stupid, would we even know that we're stupid? There'd be nothing to compare it to. So the fact that we're aware that we're so stupid means we're actually incredibly brilliant. And we just did something that so much deviates from that brilliance that we're just like how could I do that? And I'm mortified by that. So the Holy Spirit says, actually, you're so mortified because you know you're perfect. You're flawless. And you're thinking, how could the flawlessness of what I am possibly be so stupid to think that I can change my perfection by simply claiming that, by not looking at it, being unaware of it, and then claiming there's no evidence that I'm not changing it. And the Holy Spirit said, this is how you honor your creativity. You have to honor it somehow. So you honor it with this incredible stupidity, which is actually honoring your perfection. It honors your perfection. It's the only way you can combat it is just close your eyes and say, I have no evidence it's not changing. That's it. Nothing else you can do. It just proves how perfect you really are. It just proves it. It's honoring it. And I heard that, and it just flipped my whole view of everything. Because I agreed. You know, I see what you're saying. I agree. You're right. Wow. Holy cow. It completely, you know, transformed a moment as far as flipping the perspective. I said, well, what do we do about it then? I see what you're saying. What do we do about it? So we have stupidity honoring perfection. And then how do we deal with the continuity problem, Holy Spirit? And then the Holy Spirit gave me the second part of the situation and said, okay, the way out of this situation is your continuity fear, continuity problem. Understandable that we don't want to just open our awareness to reality. Like, oh, everything's always been perfect there's never any chance it could change. You know, it's like, wow, shock. Okay, there's a way, the Holy Spirit said, and then that way is, that way is. Without a second way, this is the way, is to allow perfection to honor stupidity. Allow perfection to honor stupidity. Right now, it's stupidity honoring perfection. So, what happens is perfection honors stupidity. Because perfection knows that stupidity is actually honoring perfection, you see. It knows that. It's the ultimate compliment in a certain way, isn't it? Like saying, there's nothing I can do to you, perfection whatsoever, except claim I can't see you, and then say there's no evidence that I'm not doing anything to you. That just shows there's nothing you can do to perfection. So it's honoring it. And the Holy Spirit says, that's how God sees it. That's how perfection sees us. God sees us as we're honoring God by our stupidity, actually. It's honoring God. But, of course, we don't want, we were not, reality doesn't need to honor itself. It's not like isness is saying, I really need to honor isness. No, there's no such notion of reality honoring itself. Reality perfectly knows itself. So, but our idea of wanting to change reality brings the whole idea, the concept of honoring in. Okay, so God understands this. So we are honoring reality by having to employ this completely stupid means to think that we can change it. Obviously, you know, stupid meaning we can't change it. There's nothing we can do to change it. So that's honoring what we are. And so then God says, look, what perfection, reality, is going to do, what God's going to do, is honor stupidity. Honor stupidity. Because stupidity is honoring God, actually. So, I heard this and I say, wow, I get it. Yeah, that's the answer, isn't it? And then I asked, well, what are we, why are we failing? And the Holy Spirit said, we're failing because we're trying to honor stupidity with stupidity. Okay, we're trying to get out of this thing, problem. We realize we need to honor, stupidity needs to be honored in order to set it down. We're not going to set it down until we accept the fact that it really was honoring what we truly are. It really is an honor. That's all we could come up with. That's really an honor. And so we need to honor our stupidity. It has to be honored, which is our own creativity, which is our own will, it's our own creativity, it's our own adventurousness. But what we're doing is we're trying to use stupidity to honor stupidity. And this is why you have the world in the way that it is, plain and simple. That's all it is. So people mean well. They want to honor the situation, but they're using stupidity to honor stupidity. And that doesn't work. That doesn't work. What works is perfection to honor stupidity. And that's what we haven't accepted. And so in a nutshell, this is the entire thing in a nutshell. So it's been condensed down to this incredible, you know, clear nutshell. Wow. Stupidity is really honoring the perfection of reality. And the remedy is, through a continuity fear, is for perfection to honor stupidity. Instead of stupidity trying to honor stupidity. That's it. So I was able to accept this. I was able to accept it. This is it. There's nothing else needed to know. And day has gone by with some consideration of this in various ways, also considerations of my situation, of being so terrible, and I understand, actually, my situation's terrible because it's stupidity honoring stupidity. See, I'm trying to honor it, right? Stupidity, but I've been using stupidity to honor it. High stupidity, which is why everything is actually so terrible in my life. That's why. So it started out when I actually realized that the whole situation I'm in, like I'm being like a boa constrictor, it's constricting me in so many different ways, is definitely coming from my own attempt to try and deal with some deeper issue, and somehow feeling that this is the right way to deal with it. But it's actually stupidity honoring stupidity, which doesn't work. It doesn't work. It doesn't resolve the continuity problem at all. It gives you a sense that you're honorable in some way, but it doesn't resolve the continuity problem. So, at least people can start hearing this now, the truth, and they may start backing off their stupidity honoring stupidity, which means their life is actually going to get better. It can get better in a hurry if you really back off of it. So I don't advise people to go with this whole teaching of try to desire what you want and attract what you want, all this other stuff. That's still stupidity, trying to honor stupidity, actually. It's not the way. The way is to accept perfection to honor stupidity. Because what perfection does is it honors stupidity, all of it. Not just you, everything that is happening now, everything that has ever happened, everything that ever will happen, is honored by perfection, without any exception. All time, space is honored by perfection. That is the way. And all we have to do is merely accept this. Just accept it and be aware of it. And just see the intelligence of it. You know, I was able to see the intelligence of it. And see, I can understand why this is the way. This is the way, for sure. And it all started from realizing that supreme stupidity is actually a way of honoring the supreme. Because how else can we try to separate from it except through completely stupid means that rest upon a foundation of total stupidity? That's honoring. That's an honor. That's how God takes it. Now, I was able to accept this somehow. I was able to agree. I said, yeah, that is right. That is true. I see it. It fits. It was no struggle. I just accepted it. I was able to accept it. Now, it's possible people will intellectually want to struggle with it. It's not on the level of acceptance. I just took it, you know, like medicine, you know. It's like taking medicine, really. This medicine I need to take. Okay, I took it. Wait for the results. So the spiritual path is like taking medicine. And of course you don't like taking medicine, nobody does, but you know, there's some medicine that's better than others. You say, well, I know this is good for me, so I'll take this medicine. And then you just take it and just let it do its work. I mean, once you swallow a medicine, do you really know exactly what it's doing inside your body? No. It's been stomach, acid, liver, transporting here and there, fitting into molecules. Yeah, it's just like incredibly complex. Everything that's taking place in the body is so complex. You take the headache medicine, you know, and go about your business, and before you gradually realize your headache isn't so bad anymore. It's like that. Oh, where'd my headache go? I don't know. Hopefully this medicine's fast acting. Because I got a big headache as far as my circumstances go. It's a whopper of a headache. Uh, So you don't have to figure out how is this going to work. You just take the medicine. I just accepted it. I said, well, I don't understand. I really don't agree, but I'll. Well, if you say so. Okay. No. I agreed. I said, I agree with you, Holy Spirit. I said, it's absolutely, I can see it. You're absolutely right. I agree with you. We're in agreement there. Okay, no problem. Accepted it. Through reason. My reason saw it and said, yeah, that's reasonable. It's a very reasonable conclusion to reach. So I was taking the medicine. So we'll see what happens. This is where patience comes in. You know, we don't want to get the intellect involved. You take a headache medicine and you don't want the intellect to say, okay, now, you know, where's the medicine now? What's happening to it? How's it affecting my headache? What's it doing? And you could just get into a complete state of a frenzied state, mental state. Don't want to do that. So, let perfection honor stupidity. Let perfection honor stupidity. Can consider this, the better the medicine is for us. Clearly this is the way. Clearly this is the way. Now, I don't want to count my chickens before they're hatched. I don't know how quick acting this is. I'll keep taking stronger medicine if I can. Always looking for stronger medicine, for sure. Because the stupidity, honoring stupidity thing, is out of control. It's out of control in the world. And it's going to cause enormous troubles. The kind of troubles that you feel like you've got just this massive headache. Too much of a headache. Too much. Like you're being strangled from all directions. I know, in a world sense, that how bad it's getting. And it's like, wow, this is terrible. I've got to somehow give people some hope. There's another way. So this is what it's all about. I pray to all the great, the great realizers who realize that the solution to the condemn problem is perfection, honoring stupidity. Pray for all of them to rush to our aid and help push through all those who are willing to be examples, push it through as fast as possible. And spare no effort and do as fast as possible. There's no time to wait at this juncture in the world. There's an incredible effort of stupidity, trying to honor stupidity, going on. Incredible effort. Doesn't work. It ends up in big trouble. And of course, most people are saying, well, if I can't see what the trouble is, maybe it doesn't exist, which is just a play on the same stupidity, isn't it? Of, if I can't see that reality is not changing into something else, I don't have any evidence that it's not doing it, so maybe it is. You know, this is, we don't want to keep repeating the same stupidity. We want to just acknowledge the root of stupidity. And then say, okay, let this be honored, just as it is here. Let me keep compounding it, you know. Let's just say, okay, I acknowledge this is the fundamental stupidity. Fundamentally stupid, the whole thing is fundamentally stupid. So I said, Holy Spirit, let's get on it. Let's do it. Let's do this. So is my stupidity is being blessed, you know, but see, everything is blessed because my stupidity entails awareness, right? And reality, I'm unaware. I say, I claim unaware of reality. So it's awareness. So, well, it's awareness. Awareness is aware of everything. It's all one. It's aware of the oneness. So there's some, you know, honoring that takes place. That perfection honors stupidity. And I'm just waiting for that now. I'm just letting the medicine have its effect, as it were. This is the basic principle. Now, I've spent a lot of time explaining vision of oneness and a lot of stuff, but at some point we have to get down to the nitty-gritty of the absolute fundamental root situation of our stupidity, what the stupidity is. I've seen it. It's just, I don't close my eyes. Hey, I don't have any evidence that it's not changing. This is what we do. We have a bottle here. Say, I want to change this bottle into a bird. So we close our eyes and say, okay, I think it's changing. It must be changing. And then we say, well, why is it changing? Well, I don't have any evidence it's not changing. I don't have any evidence it's not changing. I don't have any evidence it's not changing. You know? And if we open our eyes, we say, oh, it's still a bottle. See, but why have my eyes closed? I'm dreaming it's changing. I'm dreaming a dream of change. I'm dreaming a dream of change. And the Holy Spirit says, well, it's not changing. No, there's no evidence it's not. No evidence, no evidence, no evidence, no evidence. Because we have our eyes closed. We have our eyes closed. We have our eyes closed. And this is just an example. Of course, I can feel that it's still heavy, but obviously, I'm just using this to point out something as a pointer. We could cut off our feeling, too, and say, I don't feel anything, so I don't know if it's a bird or a bottle or whatever. I don't know. No evidence. No evidence. No evidence. Well, we don't have any evidence of anything. We can claim anything could be happening, right? So, if we just cut off our awareness, no awareness, and then we can say, imagine anything at all could be happening to reality. Because we're not capable of receiving any evidence to the contrary. There's no zero evidence. Zero. So, zero times zero. Perfection says, let's honor this zero by zero times zero. Let's honor this. So this is a wonderful way of looking at salvation, is actually perfection honors our choice of stupidity, which is actually honoring perfection. It's a wonderful, wonderful, wonderful circular way of bringing it all to a close. Now, what's important intuitively is that people at least realize, wow, this is in play. And then they may start backing off stupidity, honoring stupidity. They may say, whoa, just a minute, whoa. I got a bad feeling about this stupidity, honoring stupidity thing. I got a bad feeling about it. So maybe there's some other option here. I think that maybe I'm feeling like there's another option. Let's not be so quick here. And that can help. That can help the world. It doesn't do so good to talk about past gurus and sages and saviors, because we say, well, you know, we've been incredibly stupid since then. We've doubled down on our stupidity. We're trying so hard to honor our stupidity, you know. So it's always good to have those in any contemporary time, contemporaries, you know, showing that perfection still honors stupidity, because we think, well, perfection honors stupidity back then, but since then we've been incredibly stupid, way even more stupid. Actually, we haven't been more stupid, but we think we have, because stupidity honoring stupidity seems to be doubling down on stupidity, doesn't it? So the contemporaries are important. I mean, these past sages were very important to their people of their time, right? So why can't we have those of our time be, you know, valuable to people of our time? You know, that's only right. It's only right and just and fair. And so I cannot, you know, talk about sages of the past and say, hey, you know, you should be able to trust them. Well, it was the people of their time that trusted them, because they were for that time. And they said, okay, I get it. But especially going through the computer age, the high-tech age and stuff, we're in a different situation where people really feel they've doubled down on stupidity. And they say, hey, there's a way to honor, for honor stupidity that we didn't even think about. So we've already gone through that cycle of the high-tech cycle, but we're now saying, well, maybe perfection doesn't honor this stupidity. It's no longer honorable stupidity. And so we're kind of like at a stalemate right now over that situation. Got to use the will to, you know, break that stalemate. There's this lady in a grocery store today. She was trying to replace her shopping basket. Old lady, feeble old lady. And she couldn't push it in, you know, you have one nest inside the other. She couldn't push it. She was trying to maneuver it in, and I could tell she wasn't pushing it in. She was just trying to finesse it or something. And then she was fussing with the other basket. And I realized she's just not gonna be able to get it done. She's not gonna be able to get it done that way. And I just came up to her and it just says, here. I said, here. And she didn't really even see me. She kind of took her hands off and she was looking. I just took the basket, I just, poof, just pushed it, nested right in. And she looked at me like, oh, do you need the basket? Did you need the basket? Do you need a basket? Actually, that was first. I said, here, I'll get it. And she goes, oh, you need a basket? No. I said, no, no, no. And I just pushed it in. And then she goes, oh, you used force. She goes, you used force. I said, just a little. I used just a little. I just pushed it. And she goes, oh, I see. Yeah, I couldn't do that. She said, I couldn't do it. So the world's like this little old lady, you know, a little old lady that just doesn't have the will to do it. Doubling down on stupidity stupidity trying to honor stupidity has caused us all to be so feeble. And so someone comes along, just a little push, easy, little push, you see, no problem. Now, if you were going to get directions from somebody, you need to get somewhere real fast, would you go ask someone that's suffering from dementia, can you tell me how to get there? They'd say, sure, I'll try. Well, if you listen to them, you'll be there for half an hour, and it'll be more confused than when you started. So I think you go down here. Now, wait a minute, where are you going? Down there. Okay. Where are we starting from? No, wait, I'm confused. Just a second. Okay, I'll get it. And it goes on and on and on and on. What you do is you say, hey, okay, forget it. I'm going there. Poof. Just, you know, you get directions from somebody who doesn't have dementia. Well, stupidity, honoring stupidity is like a type of dementia, actually. The world's actually suffering. All the world's suffering from severe dementia. You're not going to get the answer from them, especially in a fast way. And you only end up with some really vague, fuzzy, confused, well, I'm not sure this might be it, you know. Go to someone who knows, just, hey, poof, this is it. Holy Spirit knows, hey, look. Stupidity really is honoring perfection. The answer is perfection, honoring stupidity. Okay, what doesn't work is stupidity, honoring stupidity. That doesn't work. We have a severe continuity problem, so perfection honors stupidity. Vision of oneness, that's the answer. Got it. Because we have to move fast now. We have to move really fast in the world. Really, really fast. Really fast, really fast, really fast. So, someone like myself who's not suffering from dementia so terribly because I've been working my whole life to try to get the cobwebs out, and I'm able to pass on what the Holy Spirit told me. Now, it's not as clear as the impression it gave me. The impression it gave me was just kabow, boom, wow, I see it. Yeah, you're right. It's like that. Just like that, very quick. Now this is taking a little time to you know, just maybe you've already got it, you heard it, yeah, this is it. So it helps speed things up. It helps speed everything up to talk in these terms. But the rest of the talking is just helping with the wow factor. I understand that. It is like, oh my gosh. Oh my gosh, there is an answer. Oh my gosh, we're not trapped. Oh my gosh, I think everything's going to be all right. This is a shock. And so, we just kind of spent some time hanging out, talking, that's all. reading a Sargadatta would like say something intense to somebody, and then, okay, that's it. And then spend the rest of the time, any more questions? No. Talking about consciousness, blah, 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 blah. Just allowing this, the intensity to settle into people. See, there's some intense speed up factor. Sped everything up. And then you just spend some time letting everyone kind of get used to that, you know, intense speed up. Talking about consciousness. When the teachers start talking about consciousness, I just tune it out, you know, it's like, what are they talking about? It's all nonsense. But, yeah, it's like talking about the weather, really. Listen to all these explanations, of convoluted explanations of consciousness and this reflection on the self, reflection, blah, 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 blah. Might as well talk about sports or the weather. They know that. They need to sound spiritual because everybody expects it of them, so they talk some spiritual talk. But what really is important is that the quick burst of recognition. You see, almost instantaneous. Oh my gosh. Yes, stupidity is really honoring my perfection. Wow. It is such a totally incredible realization. You just want to sit there for hours, you know, just letting it soak in. So the teacher, blah, 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 you know, gives you an excuse to stay there for a while. That's really what it is. And other people are like, they're like, what's he talking about? All this conscious, I can't quite figure it out. Nah, it's just window dressing. Just window dressing. See? They ask the Sargadatta, what can I do here and now? He says, you can realize your being right here and now. So you can see your being right here, right now. And the questioner says, that's it? And the Sargadatta says, that's it. Just that interchange, you know. Experience your being right here and now. That's what you can do. What you can do right here and now, experience your being right here and now. Your beingness right here and right now. That's it? That's it. That's all there is to it. Nothing else. It's like, wow. And then chat about consciousness, chat about this and this spirit. Okay. Window dressing. And those who don't get that, they're trying to figure it out. What's he saying? Okay. Let me write notes down. I'm going to write a book about this. Consciousness. Okay. How does this consciousness react to this and the physical and the mental and all this other stuff is just window dressing. It's all window dressing. It's all it is. That's why I say the mood of repentance is so important. It's your capacity to sit quietly for long periods of time. Because when you get this, when you realize, oh my gosh, my stupidity, my total stupidity is really this profound honoring of my perfection. You know, that is just so incredible. You realize it's a total game changer. What do? Next? Well, you let it sink in. So if you're able to sit there and listen to somebody blah, 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 blah for a couple hours, that's super helpful for you. Super helpful. And then other people think, oh, okay, he seems to have gotten something because all this talk about consciousness, and he figured it out. That's good. That's nice. But you know that's not it. But it gives you a nice, smooth, soft landing. So that's why I go on and on and on and on and on here. Just give you opportunity to if you get it, if you see it, you know, it's be like being struck by lightning or thunder or something. But this is a game changer. You know, this is a total game changer. Total game changer. And I see how the game has changed totally for me. Totally changed for me. Never be the same after seeing this. Now, I'll never be the same. So, but what do? You just hang in there and chit-chat, spiritual chit-chat. One moment, please. But by all means, make use of the spiritual chit-chat as a means to let this settle in. The immensity of this to settle in. Holy cow. Perfection, blessing, my stupidity is the way. Oh my gosh, just, you know, let it settle in. So make use of the chit-chat and the time, by all means. Yeah, you know, this 5-minute thing, 3-minute, 5-minute, that's it. No, 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 no. No. that's stupidity, honoring stupidity. Because this freed from all suffering forever. So, you know, it's like, that is so incredibly amazing. I'm just stunned by it, stunned. So you give yourself time to let the stun kind of settle into it and get used to it, and, you know, take it easy, take it easy. Don't be in a hurry. The tortoise wins this race, for sure. The tortoise just means that it's absorbing this immense great news. And so it seems to be going real slowly because it's absorbing this great good news. So the stupidity on your stupidity will just say, oh, okay, got it, thanks, I got it. Which is really stupid, right? But we're aimed towards perfection, honoring stupidity, and realizing that our stupidity is honoring perfection. So we don't need for stupidity to honor stupidity. So we don't need to be stupid to double down on stupidity. So we'll say, well, I'm gonna be wise here. And the reason I'm going slow is I'm absorbing this immense great news that I received. So I may hang out for hours just kind of acting like I kind of don't stupid and ask questions and just hang out. And other people might say, well, how come they, whatever answer is given, if they're smart, they should have gotten it right away and that's it. No, that's not it. The stunning, if you see it, the stunningness of it, the stunningly great news that I'm receiving, just stunningly great news. And people might ask at some point, you know, how in the world did you manage to handle this great good news? Well, it worked out of my whole life of absorbing the stunningly great news, like a tortoise going very slow. Going very slow so I don't go too fast. You know, if you accept it all at once, you know, kaboom, I mean, it would just, you'd set the world on fire, you know, and the world just like say, wow, it's too much. So you gotta be able to soft landing, soft landing, soft landing. So I'll keep chit-chatting away, and hopefully you keep listening. Realizing what it's all about. It's the high path. It's what works. It's what works. Put your time in. Put your time in. It's kind of like you swallow the medicine that's going to solve your problems, and you say, wow, what did I just do? Oh my gosh, I just swallowed this medicine. Oh my gosh. And you got to keep calm about it. Keep calm. I just saw the answer that sets everybody free today. I just saw the way that sets everyone free. And now I know the way, you know, and it's like, wow. It's the cure for everything. I just was told what the cure for everything is. So that's pretty big news. Pretty big news, for sure. It's hard to get any bigger news than that. I don't know what would be bigger news than that. So it's a big, you know, super big news story here I'm breaking. This channel, the video channel, is breaking the big news. It's where you go for the big news. The other stuff you realize is nothing. It's nothing. It's stupidity honoring stupidity. Here is where you get the really big news. And those who can handle this big news are very blessed and have the capacity to let it sink in. Let it sink in. Give it the time to sink in. This is the path. This is the mood of repentance. This is the mood of dedicate. This is dedication. This is what it takes. You're not sitting there because you're stupid. You're sitting there because you see how you can be free of stupidity. It's for perfection to honor your stupidity. So you're really saying, oh my gosh, I'm going to be free of all stupidity. First intermediate step, vision of oneness, perfection honoring stupidity, and then no more need to even honor stupidity. See, so I'm going to be free. So that's incredible news. It's like someone you thought was dead comes back to life, and they say, "I thought you were dead." No, I never died. Oh my gosh! And you know, people faint, and they can hardly stand the good news of somebody thought that, you know, they some soldier was lost for a long time. They thought dead for sure. Then finally shows up one day, and they say, "What? What is this? I can't believe it. It's like, is this a dream? It must be a dream." You know, it's just like the good news is too overwhelms them. So this good news I'm imparting here is just incredibly great news. So we do the honor, we honor the fact that it is fantastic, great news by spending some time with it. Spending some time with it. So we're just spending time absorbing this fantastically great news. That's what we do here. We just spend time absorbing this news. That's it. That's a very smart thing to do, actually. Okay, I got to take care of something, so we'll see how it goes here. Yeah, let the medicine work. Very great, that's it.